Welcome back, everyone. With dbt core now set up on our computers, we're ready to transform data made available by Fivetran and prepare it for analysis. As we mentioned in the last episode, dbt core allows you to utilize open source module SQL to transform your data. Let's welcome back Jack, who will help us apply those principles and create our first dbt project. Jack, I'm excited to have you back.
Thanks, Alex. Happy to be back. In this episode, we're going to be initializing our first dbt project and downloading our first free data model. I've navigated to my newly created dbt project using Visual Studio Code. Notice all the pre-built files, folders, and even a couple of models. The first thing that I want to do is add one more file, and I'm going to call this packages.yaml. This file will hold on to any pre-built packages that I will be using in my dbt project. In this case, I'm going to go to Fivetran's hub of all of their pre-built packages, and in this case, I'm going to be using the Fivetran log package. By simply copying and pasting this snippet of code and adding it to my packages.yaml file, I can download and reference these models in my project. So let's do that. Now that I've added this code to this file, I'm going to save the file and run a simple command to download it. dbt deps will download this and any upstream dependencies that the package may have. If I open up a terminal in my project and run that command, you will see all the relevant packages download. You can also find them in the dbt packages folder that is created in your project already. Okay, now that I've done this, the next step for us is going to be to add all of these files in a repository and link it to a Git repository. In my case, I'm going to be using GitHub. The first thing that I want to do is create a new blank project. To keep things consistent, I'm going to call this the same name as my dbt project, but I don't have to do that. I'm also going to make this repository private in the case that I have sensitive data. I'm also not going to add a README because when I initialized the project, one was created for me. So notice how we'll skip that step moving forward. The first thing that I do need to do is to initialize my repository to make it compatible with Git. So let's first do that. Now that I'm here, I can run git commands inside my project. Let's try one of my favorites, git status. As you can see, there's a lot of red. These files are untracked, and so what we're going to need to do is track these files before we push this up to our repository. Let's do that. Git add dash a, and again git status, should be able to show you that now they're green and now they're added. Let's make sure that we're running all these commands in order as well. And again, we're going to skip over the README portion. By committing these, I now have something to push up to my repository. The next step here is to make this our main branch. This is the branch that Fivetran will default reading from. And of course, let's remote add the origin here because I want to make sure that where I'm developing is pushing to the correct repository that I have now created. The last step here is to push this into the repository. Now that I've pushed this, I should be able to scroll back to my repository and see that all of the changes that I made are now sitting in this repository. This will allow for Fivetran to connect right into this repository to begin our integrated scheduling feature. Thanks for joining us.